This chart traces the evolution of language models in recent years, and it shows something interesting. It separates all AI models into three categories: encoder-only models, encoder-decoders, and decoder-only models. And you can see that decoder-only models have been dominating the development of LLMs over the past few years. All the AI focus is on decoders now, models like GPT or Llama that take some input and generate the output one token at a time in an autoregressive manner. But there are also other architectures like encoders. Encoders are models that take some text and generate a meaningful representation of that input, capturing its semantic and syntactic properties. This representation is not text, it's actually a numerical vector that can be further used for other downstream tasks. For example, we can use it in retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, to retrieve some additional context for our prompts. And RAG is a very popular approach in AI now, so I will quickly show you how it works in this visualization taken from this blog post from Meta. So suppose we want to use a model like ChatGPT to answer a question such as, how has Hemingway's work influenced modern American literature? RAG begins by using encoder to generate a vector representation of our question. This question vector is then compared against vectors representing documents in our database that can be relevant articles from Wikipedia, for example. Using some similarity metrics, RAG then identifies the documents most closely related to the question. And these documents vectors are created in the same way, by using another encoder to transform the Wikipedia text into vector representations. And once the most relevant documents are identified and retrieved, their content is combined with the original question prompt and processed by the LLM as usual. Encoders can be used for RAG, machine translation, many applications. But I have the feeling that many people nowadays are using large, multi-billion parameter language models for simple tasks, where encoders can be much better fit. So I highly recommend learning about them. Okay, so hopefully I convinced you that encoders are great. But the problem is this gap. Many systems and pipelines are currently based on rather old encoder models like BERT or Roberta. Here you can see that BERT is the second most popular model on Hugging Face with over 65 million downloads. I mean, on the one hand this is very impressive, but also BERT was published 6 years ago in 2018. And of course many variants of BERT have been published over the years like Albert, DeBerta, XLM, Academic BERT or Mosaic BERT, each addressing some of the limitations of the original BERT model, but only partially, not really bringing all the state-of-the-art innovations together. Well, until now, because after 6 years, BERT just got a proper modern update in this paper Smarter, Better, Faster, Longer, published by Answer AI, Lighton, Johns Hopkins, Nvidia and Hugging Face, where they present a new model called ModernBERT. ModernBERT comes in two versions, base and large. And here you can see that both versions clearly outperform their BERT counterparts. Both versions are similar in size to the original BERT models. And they are basically designed to be drop-in replacements. So if you have an old system that is based on BERT, you can simply replace it with ModernBERT and it should work. Alright, so let's see what's new about ModernBERT, what's behind all these improvements. And let's start with the training data. ModernBERT was trained on 2 trillion tokens, which is about 500 times more than the data used for training BERT. That on its own should give us big improvements, but they also focused on data diversity. And the new training data now include web documents, scientific literature, and also code. Adding code to training is huge. Previous models were mostly trained only on textual data, and that highly limits their performance on code-related tasks, for example, if you want to use them for AI coding assistance. And clearly it works, because when we look at the reported benchmarks, ModernBERT is outperforming on code tasks by a large margin. I personally have been recently using DeBerta and CodeBERT for one of my projects that involves code, so I'm very excited to try ModernBERT and compare the results. Unfortunately, the training data includes only or mostly English, so this is not a multilingual model. But I expect that someone will very soon come up with a multilingual variation to ModernBERT. The next big update is in context length. Transformer models, whether encoders or decoders, need some mechanism to specify the position of tokens in their input. Without this mechanism, they would treat all text as a random jumble of tokens, with no structure or order. BERT handles this with something called absolute position embeddings. While this approach works, it hardcodes the maximum sequence length during training, and BERT cannot process more than 512 tokens as a result. ModernBERT uses something called rotary position embedding, which is a newer approach that has been shown to work well on both short and long sequences. And they started the training on sequences with up to 1,000 tokens, but then they extended to 8,000 tokens later during the training. So that means that the model natively supports the context of 8,000 tokens, which is 16 times more than BERT. Similar to models like DBERTA, this limit is extendable, but the performance can always degrade if you go beyond the natively supported sequence lengths. ModernBERT also upgrades the attention mechanism, which is the core component of transformers. The original attention mechanism in BERT is quite inefficient because it grows quadratically with the sequence length in compute and memory. This makes it very impractical if you want to use it to process long sequences. But ModernBERT uses flash attention, which is very common in modern LLMs now. And flash attention is basically a GPU-optimized implementation of the attention mechanism that makes it much more memory efficient and also much faster as a result. But there is more. ModernBERT also uses a neat trick to be even more efficient. Instead of using global attention on every layer of the neural net, which would be slow because then all tokens would have to attend to all other tokens on the previous layer, ModernBERT alternates global and local attention. Global attention is applied only every third layer, and the other remaining layers use a sliding window where each token attends only to the 128 tokens around it. And this model uses many more tricks for better efficiency, and everything is well described in their paper. For example, things like removing bias terms so that more parameters can be used in linear layers, or unpadding and sequence packing, which addresses the overhead of padding in batches. So if you're interested in these details, the link to the paper is in the description below the video. But I think I've covered all the main points you need to know to get started with ModernBERT. Using the model is very easy, and I'll actually show you a simple example that I've prepared for you. So here I have one query, which is how many people live in London, and three short passable documents, where two mention London and one mentions New York. So we're trying to find out which document is the best fit for our query. This is basically something similar to the RAG use case I showed you before. So to do this, I'm using the sentence transformers framework that will make it very easy for us to compute dense vector representations for our sentences. And here we can load the original ModernBERT model, but someone has already fine-tuned ModernBERT on MS Marco, which is a dataset for retrieval. So I will use that instead. And all we have to do now is to compute the representations for our query and the documents and then compute a dot product. And this is the final output, which scores each document, and the top one with the highest score is the most relevant document according to our model. And I would say the answer is correct. So that's ModernBERT. This example and everything else that was mentioned will be linked below the video, so feel free to try it out and learn more. That's all for today. Please subscribe if you found it useful, and thank you for watching.